measurements that we need for making a blouse. So let's cut the lining for making the blouse. This is 80 cm fabric. This is lining fabric, which is washed and stretched, and then it is folded. The folded side is about 1/4 of bust or chest plus a few inches, like you can take about 3 or 4 inches on the side extra for the seam allowance, etc. Right? Then we press this lining fabric nicely. It is very important to press any fabric before cutting. Now we make a straight line on top, and then we know the length that we want. I've taken 15 inches and I capped 2 inches below this length. Now we extend these markings. We take shoulder. I have noted down the formulas and calculations. I have taken 7.5 inches for 34 inches chest, and then we extend this marking also. We mark for the shoulder, that is half shoulder, 7 inch plus 1/4 of an inch more. We are marking a boat neck, that is 4.5 inches. You can make it, if you want a very wide neck, then you can make even 5.5 inch or 6 inch. Neck length is 4 inch. The markings that I made, they include the seam allowance. Now we square these lines out and shape the front neck. We are cutting the front side of the neck only, of the dress also, the blouse also. We take 1 inch lesser than the shoulder and we join this marking with the shoulder. We take about 3/4 of an inch down on the shoulder and join this marking with the neckline. We need to know what is the chest. So chest, for chest line we mark 1/4 part of chest plus 1/2 inch more. You can take even 3/4 of an inch more. This extra thing is only for the darts. We mark middle of the armhole and shape the front armhole. If you want very well fitted blouse, you can measure your across front and then mark the armhole. Now the waistline, that is also 1/4 part of waist plus 1/2 inch. 1/2 inch is for the darts. You can keep even 3/4 of an inch for the darts if you want a fuller bust shaping thing. Now we join these markings. We take middle of the shoulder and then we have to mark the dart point, that is DP. Here we mark in middle, taking from up, and then here also from the folded side. On this blouse, we'll be making a side. Either we can make a side zipper, but I'll be making a back opening. So this is the front. Front will be closed. So we are making a front dart for a good shape. And then from middle of the armhole, we are extending this line to make our dart. If you have a smaller bust line, then you can take about 3 inch up and give it a shape this way, and then make it pointed. From folded side, we take about 3 inch inside. For a heavier bust, you can take 3.5 inch inside. The size here is 34 inches for the bust. Now we go up and we extend this marking and make this dart pointed. So either you can go like this. And one more thing I tell you, if you want it very pointed dart line, then you can extend these darts this way, and even this side dart you can make it, you can start making it from like about 2.5 inch or 2 inch from the side. You can, rather than 3 inch, you can mark it on 2.5 inch and then point it towards middle of the dart point. So these would be our markings, and this fitting of this blouse would be excellent. So we take about 2 inch on the sides for the seam allowance. So in case we gain weight, we can make the blouse loose. So this is the tracing wheel. We mark on the stitching line, then we cut the outlines, but the front is folded. Don't open that. We cut the front neck. You can make any shape of the neck, but here we cut this way, and then the armhole. See, it's very simple. Making a blouse seems a little complex because of the darts, but it is not. It is very easy. If you find any difficulty, you can ask me. Then we make small cuts or notches in middle of the darts, but not the middle one, okay, because that is folded, unfolded part, only the sides. Now we cut the back part. We are cutting the lining only. We keep the front, and this on the bottom we kept 2 inches extra. We don't include that. We keep either folded or we keep it extra. Because of the burst and the many darts, the front part has to be cut a little longer. Okay, but on the back side, we don't want that. Here, we mark the back part. See, I'm cutting it same as the front part, though the back part is cut slightly lesser, about 1/2 inch or 1 inch lesser than the front part, but I am cutting it same. The armhole, that has to be about 1/2 inch out than the front part, and the back neck, that will be about 1 inch up than the back neck shape. So we just go 1 inch up, like the front neck was 4 inch, so now it will be about 3 inch, okay, because we went 1 inch up. And now using the tracing wheel, we can mark on the dart, so that we get the tracing on the back part also, but we want only the waistline dart, okay, not the sides and the armhole darts or the fish line. We don't want them on the back part, so we cut the outline. I hope you understood. If you want to watch the same video on Hindi, you can watch on his Stitching Mall Hindi Urdu channel also. Okay. So now see, here it is the back part. If you watch the complete video, then you'll understand better. So now what we do, I tell you, because there is this design which is different. Okay. So on the 10 inches from up are strap starts, right? So we mark on 9 inch or 9.5, because we don't want our strap to show from the back. And then we go middle of on this 10 inch from top, we go 1 inch inside, then we give it a diamond kind of a shape from this, from top till middle. And this diamond kind of shape we give, which we shape with freehand. This is the shape that we want on our blouse, and that is the reason we'll cut from this folded side, okay, which will be stitched later on, and that was the reason why we cut it same as the front. And here we'll be making loop buttons, about like three loop buttons on the bottom side. We kept about 1 inch. Now we cut this hole. This is not very wide, but it looks very stylish and beautiful. Now we cut this middle fold. This we are cutting the back part, okay? Here we mark, and now we'll be cutting the sleeves. It is simple thing. I explained many times, but it is very simple to cut the sleeves. We press, we fold it, and now we cut both the sleeves together. We take armhole, same 7.5 inch. We go about 3 inch inside, leaving 1 inch from top. We make a slanting line, take middle of it, then we go slightly about 1/2 inch out to curve, and from middle we shape this way. Now the length of the sleeve is about 5 inch, so we can take about 6 inch. And you know, this method is very simple to make a blouse within about even less than 1 hour. You can complete your blouse or a dress. Even you can make this kind of a blouse with the skirts or lehengas, of course the sarees, and it's very simple. Once you make it, you'll love this method, and always you'll try to make using this method only. See, even if you keep back of your sleeve armhole, you can see it is same as your armhole of your sleeve. See, it's same. So either you cut the other method, that keeping your sleeve armhole and then cutting, or you use this method, you'll get exactly right sleeve, and it will fit really, really nicely, really well. So I'm explaining this because many of you contact me on Facebook, Stitching or Facebook page, and I find it really very bad that you find it difficult to cut the sleeve. That's why I have to explain, or I try to explain with every video, so it is easier for you to cut sleeves along with the dress. So here our short sleeves are done. Now we cut a small strip from the side, salvage side, to make a strap holder on shoulders. Now we cut fabric for the blouse. This is simpler because we cut the lining, so it is no brainer. Simply keep the, like, this is the, you know, the wrong side or back side of the fabric which we folded. You can see the middle side, that is the salvage side. And now we can keep the blouse piece that we cut for the front, and we'll cut the outline. Here, you know, the sari, when you get the blouse piece along with the sari, then it is generally 1 meter. But when you get fabric from the market, it is 80 centimeter that we buy. But when we buy the shimmer, or if we want to make any extra designing or length or anything that we want to add, then it's better that we buy at least 1 meter fabric or we buy more fabric if the design is so. Okay, so never think that whatever is the design or whatever is the size or whatever additions you want to make, the fabric would be exactly 80 centimeter. No, it has to be more. Or if you don't want to add the sleeves and etc., then it can be lesser. But you know, you can't compromise on the length of the blouse. So that's why the length has to be what you want. Okay, we are cutting the back part now, and this is the middle. We cut here also, and now we pin the pieces so that we don't misplace any of them. Now the same way we'll be cutting the sleeves. We placed the back side or wrong side of the fabric out and spread the sleeve, the lining part, on this fabric, and then we cut our sleeves. In the next video, I'll show you a very simple method to make this beautiful design, and very simple, without buckram, without canvas, without hooks, anything. You can make this design even less than an hour in a very simple method. Okay, this is the back part of the blouse, and here we cut two strips while we'll be making the button loops. We need these two strips to finish the back opening of the blouse. So let's go ahead. We finish the necklines. We finish the first front neckline first. So this is the back side of the fabric, and the lining is under it. We make a simple firm stitch around the neckline and turn it. Then this is the back part. This one also we have to finish the same way as we finish the front neckline. There is a slight difference that we have to add one bias tape. So we take this contrast color bias tape. This is about you can take about 1 inch wide bias tape, and then you know, in fact I'll show you two methods. Whichever you like, you can adopt that method. I leave about 1/2 inch from top. That is useful if you are interested to add dori. But here we'll be adding button, and then also I'll show you how you can leave 1/2 inch from top and make use of that space. So we just keep folding this bias strip. You can press it from the middle and then start adding to the neckline hole, and keep the lining piece, lining fabric. So our back side, that is wrong side of our fabric, is out, and our this strip, this piping is going inside. That will be visible from the right side. And if you want, you can add even a dori inside that piping. The method I had explained you earlier in one of the earlier videos. If you don't find that video, you can ask me. I'll share the link with you. So this is one method how you can do. You can use a running stitch or use pins to make things manageable for yourself. So this is one method. Okay, and when you turn it, it will be visible. So I'm adding one more stitch to it in case you want it this to be shown thinner or wider. You can make the adjustments, so it will be something like this. Now I show you another method which is simpler than this one. See, this is the lining and we have this base fabric on the right side of the main fabric, base fabric. We keep our bias strip, that is piping, and keeping about 1/2 inch from top, that is for the loop. I'll be adding a loop. We start making a stitch along this piping till the end where the buttonhole starts. Now this piping is stitched on the right side of the neck hole, back neck hole. We add this lining on top of it and then make another stitch. It serves two purposes, like it increases the strength of the stitch because we are making two stitches. Then we are, because we stitch the lining, that piping first, so now we don't have to be much careful about managing that piping. Now we can simply along the edges of this neck hole we can make a simple curvy stitch, and from top we leave again 1/2 inch. Now this is done, it is simple, isn't it? Now we turn it and see, we cut the extra fabric. This is how beautiful it turns out to be. We can make a press over it and then both our pieces are, when we turn it, both our back neck pieces are done this way. Now we add loop, that is button loops, to it. We make the loops. Here also we can take about 1/2 inch or 1 inch wide bias strip and then start making a straight form stitch. Okay, and once it is done, we take a needle and make a strong stitch to insert the needle inside this hole. A tube kind of thing we have to make. So we insert the needle and take it out from the other part of this tube so that we have a tube kind of a thing. You can make it thick or thin, or as thin as you want, and then you can cut it into smaller pieces. The piece should be as much so the size of your button could go through it, and some part should be extra on the open sides which could be inserted within our piping open space. Okay, so we insert it, we fold it and then we insert it this way. It is in fact very easy. After inserting, we close that 1/2 inch that we left and we'll cut that extra part of the loop which is open from the sides. Then we close the neckline. This is the back neckline. Okay. Now this is done. Now we cut the extra loop opening, that loop fabric that we don't need. Same way we'll be turning it, and same way we have to close this one. See, earlier I was thinking that perhaps I'll add some dory kind of thing, but then I thought loop button are smarter and much in fashion, so it is better to add loop and buttons. So this 1/2 inch I'm simply closing.
Okay, but if you want to add dori, you can add same way you can make dori and a jhalar or something, and then you can add in this half inch opening. Here also you cut the extra fabric, trim the extra anything, threads or anything. Now here also when we fold the corners and turn it, the neck, back neck would turn out to be beautiful. See, this is how it is done. Now we have the back neck this way. Here we can press it. Now we join the shoulders. So we open the shoulders. Pay some attention to joining the shoulders. If you didn't make this kind of a blouse or join shoulders this way, it is a simple method, and here the joints of the shoulder would not be visible from the right side. Okay, means from the inside it won't be visible, it will be hidden. So the joints would be closed. We'll be making strong stitch, and the joints would be on the joints, right front side of the fabric with the front and lining with the lining. And same way we'll join other shoulder also. When we turn, the shoulders would be looking this way very neatly and very clean. Now we turn the right sides of fabric out and make a running stitch all around the edges of the blouse, but we don't have to close the sides now. Okay, so this is the bottom of the blouse, and we have to just keep the lining and the blouse fabric together. So we simply make a running stitch on the bottom, on the sides, armholes and everywhere. And one more thing, now we have to finish the back button hold. This is the back side. And here we want to add 3 buttons on equal distance. So we measure and make marking. I'm adding only 2 buttons, but you can add as many or as less as you want. From the bottom, we keep about 1 inch to fold. Now we add our loops same way as we added on the top. Same opening of the button, because I think the button size would be same, you'd be keeping the same button size as I did. So here we simply keep the loop and make a stitch over it. Now on the other marking we keep another loop, same distance, same width, similar loop, same equally, you have to check they are equally placed and stitched. These 3 loops I stitched. Now I cut the extra fabric because it is not needed now, and the holes would be so neatly placed. Now we have this strip, it was cut along the side selvage, so we just place on top of this these loops, that is the right side of our blouse, right side of the fabric, okay, not the front side. Of course we are making the back side design, but this is right side of the fabric of back side blouse. We stitched, and now we'll turn this strip towards the inside. Now we make one more stitch on the edge. On the back side of this strip, we can make a running stitch or we can hem. Same way, we'll be making another strip, but this one we'll be stitching on the back side of the blouse, back side, that is lining side, and turn it towards right side. These strips are about 1 inch wide. You can keep them as wide as 1.5 inch or even lesser. Now we turn it, because these are cut on salvage side, so we can simply turn them and fold them from the top side so that we get a finished look, and turning this way we'll be stitching over it. This side we'll be placing the buttons, and this is the top side which we close. See, this is how our buttons are done, like the loops for the buttons. Now one more thing we do, we make a quick stitch all around the neckline. So this is all around our piping. This is the back neck hole. We start from middle of that and then we turn it, and towards the front neckline we go, and all around the front neckline till the end of the back neck side. The other side of the back neck, we complete that, and this way our neckline would be done. Now we make the darts. If you want to watch the complete video, you can watch that golden blouse making video. There I explain in detail, but here after finish the neckline, I show you how to do that. See, this is our neckline which is done nicely and beautifully, and you can make this kind of a neckline in any dress, frocks, gowns or any dress. Now we have the darts. So it is simple. I just show you only the fish dart and this bottom dart, because same way you'll be making other darts. And if you want to watch the complete video, you can watch that golden blouse making video in Hindi or in English, whichever you like. So we start from the wider side and finish on the pointed side, and there we'll be making two knots with our hands. Okay, we finish it, and while we cut, we leave about 2 or 3 inches white fabric, and then we make knots. That is in the later stage. And this is the middle fish dart, that we start from the narrower side, then we go wide from the middle, and then again narrower on the other end. Okay, and same way now you make all other darts. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in this comment section below. Now all our darts are done. Now we make sleeve with lining. This is also a super easy and very beautiful method of making sleeves. It is simple. This is the lining side, and below we have the fabric, and back side of the fabric and lining would be out. We make a stitch on the bottom of the sleeve, we turn it, and after turning we can press it, and then make a running stitch all around the open, all three sides of open, this armhole side and the other, both the other sides, right? Same way we'll be preparing another sleeve. So this is a simple method, and once we do this, we can add, if you have any border, sleeve border, you can place that on bottom of the sleeve, or simply make a stitch on the bottom. Now we have our sleeves done. We join these sleeves with the armhole and in middle of the shoulder of the blouse, we add this strap holder. We pin it in middle of the shoulder stitch so that we don't forget to add it later on. Now we add or we join the sleeve with the blouse armhole. The front, that is curvier side of the sleeve, with the curvier side, that is front of the armhole, and the other back side of the sleeve armhole on the towards the back side of the blouse. Okay, and if your machine, if you have the overlocking facility, you can overlock simultaneously. Now our sleeve is joined, we can press it and see this is our strap holder. Now we fold the sleeve, and starting from this end till the bottom, we close our blouse. From the back side, we make about 1 inch mark, because back side we are giving an opening for the buttons or for wearing. Now we can fold it and we can hem it, and our blouse, this beautiful dress is beautiful blouse is done. I hope you liked it, so please like this video and share it, and let me know how did you like it, and do subscribe and keep sharing. Bye bye.